So Faraday's law helps you understand two things. One is how a transformer works, or even what a transformer is. Notice that Faraday's law tells you that changing the magnetic flux through a loop of a conductor causes a current to flow. It induces a voltage difference around the conductor, an EMF, and so current flows. And current flows because the magnetic field is changing. Here we have an electromagnet. It's a DC current, just a battery, direct current. So the current flows, there's a magnetic flux, and I could move this thing around to cause the magnetic flux through this other coil to change and to cause a current to flow, which would light up that light bulb, but I don't have to move it around. I can make the magnetic flux through this coil change in a different way, and I can make a change just by changing the direction of the current. Flip the battery the other way, now the current goes the other way. What if I did that quickly? Well, then there would be the flux right here is to the right. I switched the battery, now the flux is to the left. So it changed, and while it was changing, there was a big time rate of change, and so there was a big induced current. I don't want to flip my battery around left and right all the time, but we have another way out, and that's called an AC voltage, where I just switch the voltage back and forth sinusoidally. And what happens if I switch it back and forth? Well, when it's one way, I get to flux one way, and then it switches back, and so the flux changes, and those changes in flux, time rate of change of the flux, causes current to flow. Causes the electrons in this one to move, even though they aren't connected to a battery. If I put this closer, I get a bigger effect because the magnetic field is bigger inside here, so it's a bigger flux that's switching back and forth than if I put it out here. Now, I can also increase the voltage across this coil. I get a bigger magnetic field due to this coil, and so I get a bigger switching, a bigger change in magnetic field through this coil, and I get a bigger effect. I can get a bigger effect in one more way, and that is, well, I could also put more coils here, and more coils will give me a bigger effect because each loop has an induced voltage. So if I have 50% more coils, if I have 3 instead of 2, then I'll get a bigger effect. But remember, Faraday's law tells us about the time rate of change. If this AC field is switching back and forth quicker, the period of time of this oscillation is shorter, then this will switch back and forth quicker. So the time rate of change will be bigger, and I'll have a bigger effect. And I can put all of those together and get the biggest effect. I light this light even though I don't have a battery in this loop right here. The only power source in this loop is the other loop. Magnetic field changing back and forth in the other loop is causing the flux change in this big loop, and the flux change in this big loop is causing current to go back and forth, and that's lighting the light. So that's one of the effects from this is called a transformer, by the way, when you get voltage in one loop due to the magnetic flux changing in a different loop. One other device that we can understand using Faraday's law is a generator. This is a simple version of a generator. It's got a permanent magnet here. Well, I'm going to turn on the water and it's going to hit this paddle wheel and spin it around. North is producing a flux to the right. By the time the south rotates around here, the flux will be to the left. It goes into the south pole, out of a north pole. So every time it rotates around halfway, the flux switches. If it rotates faster, the flux will switch more quickly. We use the word generator because what we're doing is changing energy of one kind, in this case, energy of water falling, into energy of another kind, and what we're changing it into is the electrical energy in the circuit. And so we'll eventually change it into light energy. So turn this thing on, and you see that it lights up a little bit. This switches back and forth. The magnetic flux is to the right, through this, and then to the left, to the right, and then to the left. It produces an AC. It produces an AC current in this circuit. If I turn it on more, well, it's going to circle faster. Of course, Faraday's law tells us that the induced voltage, and therefore the induced current, depends on the time rate of change of the flux change. So if this is changing very rapidly, then the induced current can be very big. That's how a generator works. Turns gravitational potential energy, this water's falling, and so it's losing gravitational potential energy, into some other form of energy.